In June, my normal feeder insect company was sold out of the size of insect that I needed, so I decided to place an order from a company that I hadn't shopped at in a while. On June 18th, I got a voicemail that said that my feeder insects were at the post office ready to be picked up.
Hi, Hunter. This is Deanna at the post office in and I have your mealworms here just to call you and you'll pick them up.
So I went to the post office to get my feeder insects. I had ordered some mealworms, some black soldier fly larvae, and some dubia roaches. When I got home and opened the box, what was in there is not what I was expecting. My name is Hunter Hauk, and this is the story of how someone accidentally sent me a live green anole. So I got home, and of course I was expecting it to be normal, so I opened the box, and I'm like, okay. And when I look in the box, I see that there is this deli cup, and inside of the deli cup there is a live green anole. Now, a little backstory here, green anoles are a somewhat common feeder insect that are often fed to larger birds, even lizards, and a few species of snake, but typically they don't throw those in as like a free bonus, so I was kind of confused. So it was like a Friday when I went to pick them up at the post office, and it was like closer to the end of the day when it got there and they called me. And so I emailed them immediately and then they didn't reply until the next Monday. So that whole time I was like kind of stuck here not knowing exactly what the heck was up with this green anole. When they finally did reply, they said that they had received an email from someone who didn't get this green anole who wanted it. Their order number ended in 98 and mine ended in 99, so it was just like a mix up, and they said that they would make sure that it didn't happen again, so I'm not gonna like throw them under the bus or anything. But I set this green anole up in a 12 by 12 by 18 exoterra because that's what I had on hand at the moment, and I ordered some supplies from Josh's Frogs immediately because that's where I get a lot of my supplies. And so I got like UVB and heat, some fake plants, all that stuff. But it was in kind of a temporary quarantine setup for the first little bit until all those supplies came. And of course, once they were there, it was still a quarantine style setup for the first 30 days. The anole that they sent me was like super malnourished. So if I had like ordered it for the purpose of feeding to a lizard and not them just sending it to me on accident, I would have still been pretty shocked because there was probably not much nutrition on that could be used for someone's pet either. This anole was kind of adorable, but it still kind of sucked that I had gotten a reptile that I didn't really want. I decided to make the most of it, and so I was like, I asked some of my friends if they knew whether it was a male or a female, and they said that it was too malnourished, so I was like, okay, we're just gonna go with male, and I named him Sherman because my friend told me to name him after Sherman Peabody, so there was that, get it, because he was a green anole. This anole was eating pretty well. It was devouring some small dubia roaches, crickets, black soldier fly larvae, even the very occasional mealworm, because for an animal that small, I don't try to feed mealworms super often, but it was eating whatever you would put in front of it. It was doing well, it was starting to not really show its ribs. I was so happy with the improvement that it had made since its kind of shocking start to being a pet from being a feeder. I ended up introducing this little one on Patreon because I was super excited. I'm like, hey, here is this, here's kind of its story. I kept you all pretty updated. And as you saw, it was doing very well. But one day there was something kind of strange that happened. All throughout July and August, this guy was doing great. Sherman was always basking out on his like repta hammock, I think is what Zoomhead calls it. And his cork ground and all of that, eating like a champ, doing some digging, of course lots of climbing, basking, all the things, acting like an anole should. So one day, it was feeding day, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna give this guy a hornworm as a treat. I got a tiny one, and he ate his normal food. I put the hornworm in his bowl, and he decided he was terrified of hornworms, so he dropped his tail and ran to the other side of the enclosure. Now, so of course I like took out the tail and discarded it, and I'm like, okay, well, I did some research, it should take about a month to grow back, whatever, like, I'll make sure it doesn't get infected, if it does, I'll take him to the vet, but I wasn't too terribly worried, because anoles, that kind of happens sometimes, but then he went back and ate the hornworm, so I don't know why he didn't realize that it was food in the first place before he had to drop his tail. I'd say that they are very intelligent, the way that anoles look at you and interact with you. It's just maybe they're intelligent but not smart, if you know what I mean. Now, I decided that I wanted to wait 6 months to introduce this anole on like YouTube and Instagram. 6 months after June 18th, it would have been December 18th, and obviously it isn't December 18th, so what happened? Sherman began to regrow his tail, but he started like losing some weight, and I'm guessing that was to move it from kind of his body to his tail. And his tail was probably about halfway regrown, and he was starting to gain his weight back. At the beginning of October, he did start to lose body condition again pretty quickly, which was pretty worrying. So I'm like, okay, this anole, what's going on? Talked to some people who know a lot more about anoles than I do, and they said, order a fecal test kit. So I ordered one, and unfortunately, it didn't get here in time. On the evening of October 11th, it was feeding time, and I had seen Sherman basking under his UV and heat just earlier that morning. It was the evening, and I opened the enclosure, and he wasn't like running out to get his food like he normally did, and so I knew something was up. I was kind of worried, and I lifted up the cork hide, and unfortunately, Sherman the anole had passed away. While I never asked for an anole and was never planning on getting one, I really enjoyed my time with Sherman. I hoped to have him for a lot longer than I ended up having him for, but I understand that when they're being bred and kept for being feeder lizards, their care isn't exactly great, so I shouldn't have expected him to have a super long lifespan. I did everything I could to make sure he did have a great life, but it just was kind of short, and that makes me kind of sad to think about, but I just have to remember how adorable and fun the time was with this anole. Now, you probably are like, Hunter, why are you even telling this story if it's such a sad story on the internet? And that is because I believe in sharing the highs and the lows of reptile keeping with you all. There are a lot of great moments, but there are also a lot of pretty crappy moments when you're working with live animals, and this was definitely one of them. I wanted to be fully transparent with you and let you know so that you weren't like, what's the deal with that? Because I had talked about it a little bit kind of cryptically. And I was looking forward to introducing you to the anole in December, but of course that didn't work out. I want to thank you all for sitting through this video. If there's anything you learned from it, I guess it's that you shouldn't buy feeder insects from places that also sell lizards, because then they might accidentally send you one, and then it'll be adorable, and you'll keep it, and then it will have a sad ending. Anyways, my name is Hunter Hauk. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you next week for a much more happy and uplifting video.